What does the neuroscience say about bias? There are two things in particular that happen with bias and the brain. The first thing that happens is that we gravitate to sameness or to likeness. It's called likeness bias or homophily bias, which is to say that when we meet someone, our brain, unconsciously in under a second, will say to ourselves, is this person like me or not like me? The us, the them, the in-group, the out-group. We do this in under a second, and in fact, in under 120 milliseconds, our brains will categorize the person tied back to race, age, and gender. And we say, is this person like me or not like me? If the person is like me, the brain says, go ahead, be nice, be empathetic, faster than if the person is not like me. If the person is not like me, the unconscious brain says, proceed with caution, proceed with care, proceed with apprehension. And the reason why we do this is because, at the end of the day, as humans, we're animals. We have the reptilian brain right here. The reptilian brain's purpose is to keep us safe from harmful stimuli in the environment. If you're like me, the brain says, less likely to harm me. If you're not like me, the brain says, well, could eat me, so I should be careful. So that's the first thing the brain does. The second thing the brain does is it categorizes people based on data that we intake through our senses from the environment, and then we treat people based on these categorizations. So, for example, let's pretend you're talking to a brown woman. Your unconscious brain will clock, I'm talking to a brown woman. It will go to the filing cabinet in the brain that says brown woman on it. It will open up the filing cabinet. Whatever message or meaning you are holding in your filing cabinet in that moment about brown woman will come up, and it's on that basis that we then treat the person. Which is why it's so important for us to be paying attention to what message or meaning are we absorbing in our interaction with the woman, what we're absorbing from the media and society at large, what other people tell us, because what we hold in our filing cabinets tied back to people's cultural identities often is incorrect and is riddled with bias, and it's on that basis that we're treating people.